Welcome, I'm Annika. Let's sit your bums down on your mat and get started. Right, the body is an energetic system. Energy flowing through. Think of a plug in your house. Needs to be grounded. So your body is an energetic system that sometimes need to be grounded. When you go to bed at night, you are laying flat, lots of body touching the ground, grounding your energy. So right now, as you close your eyes, just focus on the parts of your body that are touching the ground. And if you've got a nice big butt, that's a lot of grounding going on. So enjoy it. Yeah, it's good to have a big bum. Deep breath in, exhale it out through the mouth. And again, deep inhale. Deep exhale. And maybe using this extra energy of the full moon
to focus on something you need to move out of your life. Something you could do with less of. Maybe it's a thought pattern, maybe it's a behavior, maybe if it's even a person that you could do with seeing less of, listening to less, being influenced by less.
You've just got to tune in and ask. And the more we learn to ground down and tune in, the more stuff will begin to shift in our lives.
Take a deep inhale and reach the hands high above the head, interlacing the fingers, turn the palms up, and just extend the palm up, look up. Good, exhale the hands behind the back, interlace the fingers once more, take an inhale, and as you exhale, draw the chin down, draw the shoulder blades together and lift the hands off the back, just releasing. Good, take a deep inhale. Just bring the hands by the sides, up and overhead with the right hand. Pressing down through that sit bone and reaching with the fingertips. Reach, 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 look up. Sweep the hand round the front in a half circle, other side, up and over. Pressing down and reaching across. What a great extension, good. Exhale, circle the hand down in front of the body, big half moon shape. Inhale, one more time, each side. Reach, extend, and exhale, sweep across. Inhale, reaching over, other hand. Reaching across as you exhale. Taking a little twist now over to the left. Keep the body low. Keep the hip bones rooted into the ground. Slowly release across to the other side. Nice and slow, nice and low. Twisting over to the right. Take a breath and inhale, come back through center. Inhale, lengthen, come onto your fingertips. Exhale, walk the hands forward. Oh, you feel how nice and stiff you may feel. Or maybe I'm just projecting. Turn the hands over, take a deep breath, and relax the head.
Nice deep inhales in through the nose, out through the nose. Turn the palms over, press yourself up nice and slow, head and shoulders come up last. Take an inhale and reach the hands out and up. Take a twist out to the left. Bring the hands down. Gaze behind. Try to draw that shoulder right back. Good, come back to center. Take an inhale, lift the spine up before we ask it to move. All the way over to the other side. That's it, you can use your hand on your knee to draw the body round. Come back to center, reach up. And just spread the fingers. I want you to reach with the hands and feel. Gaze up, feel alive, feel the air around you. You bloody woke up. Forget everything else. Look around. Good, now draw the hands across the body. Give yourself a big squeeze. You're doing great. Exactly where you are. Figuring shit out like everybody else. Take the hands behind. Interlace the fingers one more time. Squeeze the shoulders. Gaze up this time. Opening the heart. Activating that energy. And now let's release the hands. Find your way onto all fours and activate the breath. So curl the toes under. This time, turn the fingers towards the knees for me. Press the heel of the hands down underneath the shoulders. Cat-cow, drop the belly, lift the nose. Exhale, release the toes, push the mat away. Draw the hips back towards the heels, just so you get a release down the back of the wrist. Let's just sit with that for three breaths. Relax your head. Curl the toes under. Inhale, drop the belly. Press the mat away. Suck in the belly. Release the toes. Three breaths here. Slowly, slowly release the hands back to the front. Curl the hips high. Take downward facing dog. So take the feet apart. Arrange your hands, maybe deeply bend one knee, push the heel back in the other side. Switch sides. Inhale, exhale, push the heel down. Take a few more. Really spread the fingers and almost claw your mat. Push back, gaze at your belly button. Exhale, drop the knees to the mat. Walk the hands all the way up. Reach up. Oh, as high as you can, right hand onto the side. Left hand reaches up and across. Inhale, center, reach up. Exhale, other side. Inhale, center. Bring the hands down behind the hips. Bring the elbows together. Press the hands into the hips for a little back bend. Really press the hips forward. Draw the shoulders back. Slowly release. Walk the hands forward. Find downward facing dog. Maybe taking your right hand, touching your left ankle. Draw the body in. A little bit of a spinal twist. Release, and the other side when you're ready. Releasing, coming onto the toes. Take the heels over to the right. Press back. Knife edge of the feet. Through center, other side, and press back. Come back to center, push back to the heels. High on the toes, bend the knees. Slowly tiptoe to the top of your mat. And dangle, grab your elbows, relax your head, shake it side to side. So these forward folds, shut down and relax your nervous system. Bringing your fingers in front of your toes on an inhale, right hand high to the sky. Just bend into your left leg. Slowly release, other side, inhale. Bend into the right, gaze up. Bring both hands to the shins, look forward, press back. Draw the shoulders back and fold in, look at your knees. Inhale, push down with the feet and rise, nice and strong. Reach the hands high. Hands come to heart and breathe. Bring your hands down by your sides, Tadasana. From mountain pose, take an inhale, reach the hands high. Take hold of your left wrist, take it across. Inhale, reach up, lengthen, exhale, other side. Inhale, nice and tall, take your back bend, squeeze the shoulders, gaze up. Inhale, nice and tall, exhale, swan dive in. Good, halfway lift. Palms down, take the feet back, you can come to all fours, or you can find plank, your choice. If you're in plank, engage the belly button, draw it up into the spine. Slowly, lowering down, elbows by the ribs. Hovering, releasing all the way down. Slowly come on up to cobra. Soft elbows, just roll to one side. Gaze over the shoulder. Inhale through center, other side. Inhale through center, curl the toes, hips high. Down dog, five breaths. Come onto the toes, bend the knees, walk, step, float, back to the top. Halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Come all the way up, inhale. Grab that left wrist, last round. Just take this round by yourself. I'm just gonna shut up talking. Imagine that. Everything is possible, almost. I'll meet you in Tadasana, mountain pose. Re-engage that breath. Conscious breath work. Good, now bend your knees, sink your hips. Second warm up, second flow. Chair pose. Try to relax the tailbone. Gaze at the hands. Pick up all 10 toes. Draw the belly button in. Bring the hands to heart. Twist out to the right. And draw that left knee back. See how it kind of sticks out? Pull it back. Gaze up and push the hands down to the sternum. If you'd like to open your wings, use that bottom arm to give your spine a little bit more rotation. Come back to center, stay low. Twisting out opposite side. Draw that right knee back, push the hands, gaze up. Open out. Inhale, come back to center. Exhale, fold in. Halfway lift, flowing through to down dog. You could simply step back, skip the vinyasa. And take a little more gentle practice. Zipping the toes together. Left leg high to the sky. Point the toe, push back with the heel. Open out the side body. So you gaze under that left armpit. Curl the heel into the bum, rotate your ankle. Good, take an inhale, point the toe back. Bring that left knee to the right elbow, twisting the opposite way. Kick the leg high, gaze between the hands, bring the foot through. Drop the back heel and I'll meet you in your warrior number one. Lift the hands up, lift the sides of the body up and lower the hips down. And breathe. Nice strong warrior one. Release the hands behind the back, interlace the fingers, clasp, draw the heart up, squeeze the shoulders. Exhale, dive in, bringing that left shoulder to the inside. Humble warrior, relax the head, look at your belly button. Try to float the hands off the back. Take an inhale, come on up, straighten the legs, grab that left wrist. Sky Archer, draw the body up and back. Gaze up. Release the hands, right hand down to the inside of the left foot. Pick up your back heel and open out to dragonfly twist. Good, lower the hand, frame the front foot, drop to the back knee. Draw the hips back towards the back heel. Into Hanumanasana, half split. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold. Look at your big toe. Tilt the tailbone. Back and up. Breathe. Take three breaths here. Walk the hands forward, plant that front foot and kick up the back foot, standing split. Draw the body down towards that straight leg. Good, now bring your right fingers, your left fingers in front of your left toes. The right fingers go high to the sky, open out, half moon. Flex that back leg nice and strong. Soften, drop the back leg. Lift that left hand up and over, reversing your warrior. There you go. Dip into that front leg and gaze to the fingers. Slide the other hand down the leg, or maybe you take the wrap. It's up to you what feels good. Elbow to knee, keeping that front leg bent. Up and over. Reach, reach, reach. Hands come down, feet go back, take your vinyasa. Five breaths down dog. Right leg, press it high. Push back. Open out the side of the body. Good, now curl the heel into the butt. Lift the knee. Maybe rotate the ankle. Take an inhale, point the toe, gaze between the hands. Bring the foot through and seal the back heel down. Pressing through that front leg, rise up nice and strong and dip in. Lift. So you're pushing down, but you're lifting with the upper body. Breathe. Hands behind the back, clasp them. Take a back bend. Gaze up. Exhale, dive in. Get that right shoulder inside of the knee. Lift the hands off and gaze up at your bits. Inhale, come on up. Straighten the leg. Lift that right wrist all the way up above the head. Draw back like a bow and arrow, sky archer. So this first round, we take about 3 breaths. Just to feel each shape, release. Left hand down, dragonfly. So the back heel comes off so the hip can come round. Reach up. High blue. Place the hand down, frame the front foot. Drop to the knee, walk the hands back, Hanumanasana. So you try to extend that front leg. There can be a bit of a bend, that's okay. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, fold, tilting the tailbone back and up. That small, subtle move gets you right in here. Walk the hands forward, standing split. Fire up that back leg. Walk your right fingers in front of the toes. Open out to the side, half moon. We're going to soften that front leg, drop the back foot. Reverse warrior, dip in. Maybe wrapping the hand. Elbow to knee. Release and extend. Could also take a wrap, if you like, on your extended side angle. So start to play with your shapes. Release, take your vinyasa. Maybe you kick the leg back. Dive into your chaturanga, your choice. Five breaths. Get that fire stoked in your body, in your belly. That manipura chakra, that yellow solar plexus, where all your power comes from, your fire. In your belly. It's a furnace. Stoke it up with your breath. Come high on the toes, bend the knees, walk, step, maybe float to the top of your mat. Halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Bend the knees, sink the hips, chair pose to end. Hands to heart. Tadasana. Find your center. Find your feet, find your toes, find your fingertips. Feel it all. Second round, we'll start to move a little with the breath now. Bend the knees, sink the hips, twisting right. Opening the wings. Inhale, center, stay low. Twist. Take your time, feel your shape. Inhale. Exhale, fold in. Halfway lift. Flow through to down dog, however that looks for you. Just being mindful, get your elbows into your sides. Now you could always float the knees. Downward facing dog, Adho Mukha Svanasana in Sanskrit, the language of yoga. Left leg high to the sky, press back. Draw the heel into the butt. Maybe flip your dog this round if it's in your practice, whatever that looks like for you. Flip it back, point the toe, in between the hands, bring it. Drop the heel, come on up. Warrior number one. Release the hands, clasp them, open up, back bend. Exhale, dive in. Inhale, come on up, Sky Archer. Straight front leg, lift up and over. Release to a to dragonfly twist. Drop the hand, drop the knee, half split or full split if you're ready. Walk the hands forward, kick up that back foot, fire it up. Maybe you try to hold your ankle. Have a little play with your balance. Relax the left fingers down, open up, half moon. Another balance. Maybe pressing so deeply into that bottom foot you can float your fingers. Soften the front leg, drop the back foot, reverse your warrior. That's it, release it. Elbow to knee, flow through the other side. Continue it down, take your chaturanga. Down dog, zip the toes together. And we'll do the same. Right side, push back, curl the heel in, flip your dog. Flip it back, point the toe in between the hands, drop the heel. Inhale, come up, warrior one. Release the hands, take a back bend. Exhale, fold in. Inhale, rise. Sky Archer. Dragon flies, so left hand down. Back heel off. Good, drop the hand, frame the front foot, half split. Oof. Fire up, standing split. Maybe test your balance on this foot. Notice if there's a difference, which side of the body. Right fingers come down in front of the toes. Open up, second balance, half moon. Ardha Chandrasana. Does that sound Sanskrit enough? Drop the back foot, come on up. Elbow to knee. Continue down, Chaturanga. Five breaths, down dog. Always child's pose. If you're getting a little tired, we're gonna do one round. One more round after our last chair pose. Come high on the toes, bend the knees, walk, step, float, top of the mat, halfway lift, and fold. Bend the knees, sink the hips, chair pose. Hands to heart. Mountain pose, Tadasana. Last round, bend the knees, sink the hips. Chair. With a twist. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Fold in. Inhale. Flow through to dog. Sipping the toes, left leg, flip your dog, or just rotate your ankle, or take rock star, any expression you want, your practice, your body, as long as I keep you safe. Your teacher is your guide. Clasp your hands, but remember your inner guide, your own common sense, is way smarter than I am. Smarter than you are. Your mind. Come on up, Sky Archer. This is a tough one. It's good. Not that we need to label anything, but we do. Dragonfly. Half split, or try a full split if you like. Oh. When I think I was 10, I could bang these splits out. Not happening, it's all good. Long time since I was 10. Standing split. Walk the hands, half moon. Reverse your warrior. Take your time. Elbow to knee, extend. If you want to try the wrap, wrap the hand around. This hand underneath, open out. You might just want to play this round. You might just want to take your vinyasa and go to down dog. You could also, if you've got your wrap, toe heel that back foot in. Let's play a moment. And maybe draw the toe in. Slowly start to stand. Ow, I got cramp. And extend. Crap, stunted bird of paradise. Slowly make your way down. Release it down. Take your vinyasa. If you're already in down dog and been waiting for us, it's all good. You get a little break. Zip the toes, we'll do the same. Right leg high to the sky. Flip your dog, enjoy it. Flip it back. Drop the heel and rise. Warrior number one. Clasp. Reverse. Good. Humble warrior. Come on up, Sky Archer, up and over. Dragonfly twist. Bring the hand down, Hanumanasana, half split, full split. Oh. Make your way into standing split. Maybe play with your balance. Find half moon. Reverse your warrior. elbow to knee, extend. If you'd like to play with the bird of paradise, wrap the hand, fingers point down, palms face out. Take the hand underneath as though you're smacking your right butt cheek. Try to clasp your fingers together, hooking them. Slowly toe heel the back foot in. Draw the other toes in. And slowly, I'm going to turn round. Start to rise. Nice and slow. Keep your gaze on the floor and maybe extend the leg. Slowly lower. Release the hands. Take your last vinyasa. Notice the heat in your body now, the fire. Inhale onto the toes, bend the knees, walk to the top of the mat. Halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Now bend the knees, sink the hips, and stay here for me. Bring the hands to the heart. Stay low. See if you can cross your left ankle on top of the right knee. You may need to come to a wall. That's okay. You're making a figure four and drawing the elbows, the body in. So just a little bit of balance work. You've got a lot of stabilizer muscles in the ankle. The core needs to be tight. Your gaze needs to be steady. Slowly, slowly stand. Lift the knee. Lift the knee. Open it out to tree. Doesn't matter where your foot lands, just leave it there. You can grow your tree if you like. You could open your branches. Gives you a little more balance. Release the hands behind. Release the knee all the way behind. Draw the body forward into airplane degasana. Now try to drop that left hip. Flex the back foot. Slowly, slowly bring the feet down, lift the hands up, reach up. Step the feet apart, open out, take a back bend, and exhale, fold in. Crown of head to the floor. Shake the head a little side to side, take five breaths down here. Drawing the body in a little deeper. Releasing the hands underneath the head, toe heel the feet in a little bit and lower the hips into a squat. Malasana. Bring the hands together, press the knees out with the elbows. Just releases that hip a little. Lower the hands down, lift the hips back to the sky. Toe heel the feet, hip distance apart. Bend the knees, sink the hips. Here we go. chair pose. Dip down. Bring the hands to heart, crossing right foot this time over left knee. So find your balance point on the ground. You can come to a wall or something to hold on to if you like. You got to work these muscles, these stabilizers. Slowly begin to rise into tree. You can lift your hands, open your branches. Releasing the hands behind, releasing the leg behind. Come into aeroplane, digasana. Drop your back hip. Inhale, feet together, chair pose. Rise on up, take a back bend. And exhale, lower the hips down to the ground. Sit down. Just pick up the toes. Draw one hand up, other hand up, and lift. Last little bit of energy into your boat. Heart means it worked. Extend the legs lower halfway down. Ardha Navasana. And just lower all the way down. Lay down. Hug the knees into the chest. Give yourself a squeeze. Grounding the spine now. And just circle the knees around. Just place your hands on top of them as though there's a clock face on your lower back, on your sacrum. Other side. Just place the feet down on the ground, hip width apart, hands down by your sides. And on your next inhale, start to peel the tailbone off the mat. Keep your chin where it is, back of the head onto the mat, lifting the hips into bridge. Just press through the fingers, press through the feet. Vertebrae at a time, lower down. And let's take one more. So inhale all the way up. Exhale all the way down. Good, soles of the feet come together. Allow the knees to fall apart. Maybe left hand on your heart, right hand on your belly. Maybe you want to close your eyes for a moment. slowly, slowly release the hands. Draw the knees into the chest. Extend the feet up just a little. See if you can take hold of the outside edges of the feet. And extend the feet to the sky. It's called happy baby. Try to draw the knees outside of the armpits. You can rock a little left to right if that feels good for you. Slowly extending your right leg long, hug your left knee in. When you're ready, draw that knee across the body and over to the floor. Maybe opening the other arm up and across and take your gaze over the shoulder for a spinal twist. Slowly release, draw the knees back to center. Squeezing in the right knee, extending the left leg long. When you're ready, draw that knee across the body. And if it feels good, open out the right hand. You can use your other hand just to keep your leg down. Slowly releasing. Just wrap your arms around your legs and give yourself a big hug. And when you're ready, open out to final resting shape. Make a star shape, take up space. Soft inhale and exhale, just let everything go. Take a soft inhale, a soft exhale. Just bringing yourself back into your body. Opening the palms, pointing the toes, breathing in, and maybe reaching the hands above the head. Drawing the knees into the chest and just slowly finding your way onto your side. Take a breath and find your way to a seated position. You can close your eyes, draw the hands into the heart and bow the head. Take a soft inhale and let it go. Remembering what you need to let go of in the next few days. What will serve you best to release? Thank you all for gathering, for joining with you deep down in there, and with all of us together. Sending healing vibes, just good energy out there to anybody that's struggling today, maybe tuning in right now. Take a deep breath. It's all good. Namaste.